impressed. The brains are in the server room undergoing training. Knock yourself out. Go nuts.
I'm sorry, sir. Our
watch out! They keep on coming! My legs!
Sundowner contacted you from the top floor. Time to make your way up there.
Elevators appear to be disabled, which we should have expected, I suppose.
I will access the control unit. Perhaps you can hack an elevator and make it operational.
Ooh, splendid idea! By all means, yes! It seems the guards are storming the building. Titan, get back to the entrance. Buy me some time to get this elevator operational.
You can control that UGD as well, yes? Give them hell! The elevator drivers. Use the weapons around you to slow them down. Throw everything at them you can.
Wunderbar! My hack was a success! Board the elevator, right? For security purposes, the building is divided into upper and lower halves. The lower area consists of offices and meeting space for staff and visitors, while confidential military projects and technical research are restricted to the upper levels.
So that's where the brains in the server room will be, up top.
Indeed. But that elevator can only access the lower floors. You need to get to the 20th floor and past the security gate there to reach the upper area.
Let me guess. Time to find another left hand?
Well, that is the problem. Security cyborgs would not have sufficient clearance. But managers and senior staff have already been evacuated, no doubt.
So...
The only option is to cut the power to the security gate, which will not be easy. It is powered by no less than 3 systems, including a backup power supply. You will need to destroy all of the electrical control panels to disable them. In any case, you should arrive at the 20th floor soon. The electrical panels are most likely hidden in the walls. Use your enhanced AR to search for any unusual heat sources inside the walls there. There should be an electrical panel nearby. Use your enhanced AR to locate it.
No choice now.
You'll pay for that.
There should be an electrical panel nearby. Use your enhanced AR to locate it. Good. One down, 2 to go. Keep at it, Raiden. There should be an electrical panel nearby. Use your enhanced AR to locate it. Just one more.
They keep on coming.
Take care of security. Now, head back to the gate.
Enemy sighted!
Shall I activate your pain inhibitors now?
No, keep them off. I need it this way.
As you wish. I must say, I have turned more than a few men into cyborgs. But you, well, your past is most,
What you getting at, Doc? Most of the time, you're working with First World ex-military. Grown men. Compared to the average Third World child soldier, I can't really complain. Most of them. They're the sort of gorillas your typical patient gets paid to slaughter.
Perhaps, but...
This shouldn't be news to you, Doc. Look, just help me take care of those brains after I bring him back. I do my business, you do yours.
Yes.
They're pouring in from everywhere. This is crazy.
You do not have to fight every enemy you encounter, right? Try and keep moving. Nice of them to blow open the door for me, yeah? Idiots. The way is up now, yeah? Almost there. I have just finished analyzing the latest security data. You should find an indoor garden up ahead.
A garden? Sounds fancy.
A Japanese garden, to be precise. It is an area set aside for VIPs. Apparently, one of World Marshal's directors is a rather serious Japanese culture enthusiast.
All right. So what's this got to do with me? Is there something I need from the garden?
Not at all. You need only pass through that area to arrive at a freight elevator. I found a route to the elevator controls through the unit we hijacked downstairs. I have located the server room as well. You can reach it via the freight elevator.
Great work, Doc.
Elementary, my dear Raiden. Now, head for the garden. It is sealed. I very much doubt you can get through there. The catwalk above you is connected to a corridor meant for transporting materials. You can take that to the elevator. Catwalk straight ahead to reach the elevator.
My apologies, Raiden. I seem to have fallen behind.
No worries. Actually, I should thank you.
What are you talking about?
If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have gotten Jack back.
Then, that is your true nature.
More or less. Still interested?
I find no reason to alter my objectives. From the moment we met, you have acted on emotional urges. You speak of protecting those weaker than you. Such people number in the billions. It is impossible. You cannot save every human being in the world. You cannot save every street child. After extended observation, I have come to a conclusion. Your actions are rooted in affinity for those from similar circumstances as yours.
Huh. Guess so. Not much of a superhero after all, huh?
However, your emotional status is understandable. Perhaps I share this same affinity.
Well, if that's what you feel, then glad to have you along.
Roger.
You can reach the server room via the freight elevator just ahead.
Zug abreiten! Another freight platform! Look out! Incoming!
From the top floor to the freight elevators. Your path to the server room leads right through them.
Ahead?
Yes, according to what I have here.
What should I expect to find? If they're VR training those brains, I'm guessing it won't look like your typical IT department.
Quite right. Most of it will likely be occupied by life support units, feeding oxygen and nutrition to the brains they have stored, you know. They would also need a server to feed them the VR data, but in terms of structure, it's really more brain storage and maintenance than a server room. But no doubt it makes a convenient euphemism for what they are really doing there.
Yeah, like how CIA agents refer to where they work as the company.
Indeed. Something like that would never arouse the suspicions of rank-and-file staff who may hear it. And I'm sure those complicit in this operation feel better not calling it the VR training room. Even something so simple as a name can help one ignore the truth of what they are doing. Truly fascinating how the human brain works.
So this whatever room, that's where Sundowner's waiting, right? If he wants a fight, I wish he'd just get on with it. He didn't seem the type to run and hide.
Well, he is in charge of security, but I suspect this is not about business. If I had to guess, I would say he is toying with you, testing you, perhaps.
Whatever he's doing, it won't change what's going to happen once I finally catch up with him.
Controlled by an AI.
soon? Well, if it's AI controlled, it should pose no problem for you, yes?
Disrupt the students while class is in session. I believe you're familiar with the lesson plan. The same regimen you went through in Liberia. Effective program. Just look how you turned out. Of course, running it in the real world just got a bit too complicated. Doing it virtually, though, no fuss, no muss. Straight to the brain. It's like a dream. Well, maybe dream is the wrong word. They do kill some POWs, some civilians. They enjoy it, though. We give their pleasure centers a nice big jolt every time. Plus, they get a shiny new body as a graduation present. Another thing you have in common. I chose this. They're kids, you son of a bitch. And kids are cruel. All people are by nature. They just lose touch with it as they get older. Start thinking they know right and wrong. That's immoral. War crime this, code of conduct that. Kids, you can mold. Manipulated to performing all kinds of atrocities. And there's nothing like a good atrocity to keep a war going.
That's why I'm shutting you down.
You just don't see the bigger picture, do you? Say you bring this whole place down.
waltz out of the rubble with all these precious brains. Nothing changes. All the guys in charge are long gone. We've got offices around the world. We're just suppliers. We don't create the market for war.
And who does? The Patriots are gone.
Those guys just manage the war economy. They didn't invent it. Did you think every battle in history was all part of some big old conspiracy? Bullshit! War is just part of who we are. Why fight it? Anyway, none of this will matter in 3 hours. Demand for PMCs is about to skyrocket, like the good old days after 9/11.
What are you talking about?
Not here. Follow me.
Raiden, get Sundowner. Do not lose him this time.
Up here without damaging the merchandise.
What happens in 3 hours?
Don't matter. You're too late. Even at Mach 2, you wouldn't make it. And killing you is gonna take some time. Slow and painful.
To attack so it does not detonate. If you can only hit the right spot with your blade, maybe you can drop his gun.
Me. Tabs open, Jack! Tabs it down!
Shaving?
I've taken Marshal HQ.
Yeah. I have just entered Denver airspace. I will be there soon.
Hurry.
Driver, what Sundowner said.
I know. Anything that'll rival 9/11 cannot be good.
And in 3 hours, maybe less. He said even Mach 2 could not get there in time.
If he was serious, that's over 4,000 miles away.
4,500. So whatever it is, it's not happening on American soil.
If it's gonna spike demand for PMCs, it's gotta be a political hotspot. A coup or civil war in a stable region wouldn't have a domino effect.
And they'd want to draw in a superpower. No.
What?
The president. He's on his way to Pakistan. If something happens to him there...
Oh, shit! The War on Terror Part 2.
Contact the military.
Official channels are frozen since Mexico. Unofficial channels will take too long.
Besides, what's our proof? Who's gonna believe us over World Marshal?
Then we have to get there first.
Nevozmuzhno! Impossible! It is the other side of the planet. Even if we were in the world's fastest jet right now, it's not even close.
Hold up. It's not a jet we need.
Courtney?
An RLV would make it with time to spare.
That's...
Mach 23, if we're talking one atmosphere. 17,650 miles per hour.
That would make Pakistan in under half an hour.
Right. Contact Solus.